Protocol stack has totally changed as well compared to the previous one that you saw, where we had RFCOM and so on and so forth. Here, they have actually three layers, if you want to call them. One is the part of it is for control, another part what we can call host, and finally application. In the control, they have these two layers, two and a half layers actually, because half of this host controller interface belongs to the control, another half belongs to the host. But basically, you have the link layer, in the physical layer, and the direct test mode. This is not defined here in the next few slides, so I will have to figure out what is DTM. But anyway, so the link layer is how you connect. This is that software host controller interface is the software that makes it independent of the chip. And then you have logical link controller. Then there are two protocols here, security manager and attribute protocol. So attribute protocol simply is exchanging the attributes, exchanging the profile. Okay, security manager is encryption, etc., etc. So the new layer here is called generic attribute profile. All right, and that is new because previously the profiles were very, very limited. So you could connect Bluetooth or 15 different things maybe, okay, because there are 15 profiles. Now there are so many sensors of different kinds. Right, so they cannot just limit to 15 or a small number. So they have created this new profile called GAP, I mean generic attribute profile. Okay, it's called GATP, isn't it? GATT, generic attribute profile. Okay, and then generic access profile, and then the application. So it has become more general now, basically. By having generic attribute profile, now we can define an attribute and use it. Obviously, how do you define the attribute? By using XML. So if you are a thermostat, you define your profile, and then whoever wants to read thermostat will know what you are transmitting, right? So that is what GATT profile is. So the profile style has changed from the previous Bluetooth. In the previous Bluetooth, it was just designed. People who designed the headset sat down together and said, okay, every headset will do this. And so on and so forth, right? Mouse, keyboard, and everything else. But now it is generic, almost infinite. So this one is used to define the data formats and interfaces with the attribute protocol. And the data formats are defined in type, length, and value, TLV, right? TLV encoding is used. So everything is defined as what type it is, how much is the length, and what is its value. Each attribute has 16-bit universally unique ID, UUID, standardized by Bluetooth SIG. So now, even though the attributes have become infinite, actually they're not infinite because there can be no more than 2 raised to 16 attributes. Each attribute is given a particular number. And that number is in the Bluetooth standard. So if you want to have temperature, you have to get to the Bluetooth standard and say, well, how do I code temperature? They say, okay, your temperature is number 239. Then you say, okay, what is location? Location is 235. So then there's a number, right? For each attribute, there is a particular number, which is called UUID, universally unique ID. So nobody can use that number for any other attribute. 128-bit UID if assigned by a manufacturer. Now, if you don't go to Bluetooth SIG, where you can get a 16-bit UID, then you can define your own 128-bit UUID. And generally, when you do such things, what you do is your first 22 bits or so will indicate the manufacturer, and then the rest will indicate what that attribute is. Allows any client to find a server and read and write data. Allows servers to talk to generic gateways. So now everything can become generic here. And you can have AES 128 encryption. And everything is encoded in XML. And so now you can develop new applications very fast without having to worry about the whole thing to be defined by Bluetooth. All the Bluetooth SIG does is gives a standard number to each attribute. So that is the new part, this blue thing, that's why I put in the blue thing, is the attribute profile. The attribute protocol to pass that information, and an access profile is basically to access the same thing and applications on the top of that. The next thing is gateway devices. So mostly we need gateways now, because if you want to talk to the rest of the world, Bluetooth will not go to the rest of the world. So you talk Bluetooth to something that becomes a gateway at the router to the rest of the world, in this case, the cell phone, a tablet, a laptop, or whatever. I mean, basically, you know, you connect to that and then it connects to the rest of the world. So any device that can help connect a Bluetooth device to the internet is called a gateway. A generic app can forward the data to the URL sent by the device. So there is an app. By app, we means this application here. This says send to URL. So, for example, if you have a security system at your home, your security system might tell your phone to send whatever data, whether it is picture or video or whatever, to some website. If it is a baby monitor, same thing, you know, it can go. But generally, these could be Wi-Fi enabled, in which case they directly talk to the internet. If they are Bluetooth enabled, then they go through something which is connected to the internet. So what are the applications of BLE, the low energy Bluetooth, or Bluetooth Smart? So its initial, by the way, its initial name was Bluetooth Low Energy, BLE. But then it became a fashion to call everything smart. So Zigbee also became Zigbee Smart, and other protocols, we'll see, they are called themselves smart. So Bluetooth changed its name to Bluetooth Smart. You can use it for proximity in the car, in the room, in the mall. So basically, you can figure out where you are, how far you are from things like that. Locator, keys, watches, and animals. So nowadays, they sell these little tags, which can be used to locate objects. How many people have seen those tags? At least on paper, on the magazine. But they don't cost anything. Actually, I just bought two tags for $2 each. But they don't do anything either. On the very first day, I connected it, and yeah, I press the button and I can find them. But after that, you know, they become totally useless because they're $2. What can you expect for $2? And these things are very common nowadays. Watches, animals, you can put them on animals, and hopefully they are within 100 meters. If they are not within, Bluetooth only goes so far. Actually, 100 meters is too much, 30 meters maybe. You know, unless you happen to be very close to the object, you really can't find it. So if it is in the other end of your house, it doesn't work. Health devices, heart rate monitor, physical activities, thermometers, sensors, temperatures, battery status, tire pressure, remote control, all of these can be done with Bluetooth now. Now there's another application, beacons. So basically, when your Bluetooth is on, it's always sending these advertising messages which says, I am here, does anybody want to connect? Your phone is already advertising, okay, all the time. So my Bluetooth is off right now. But if it was on and I go to a store, the store knows that I came in. You know how? Because they can listen to the Bluetooth, and then the Bluetooth, I will say my MAC address is so-and-so. And from that MAC address, they know this is Rajan's phone. Because last time when I was paying at the booth, they knew my credit card number, they knew my name, and they knew my phone at my MAC address. Right? So when I go again next time, they say, oh, this guy bought the tire last time, so let us sell him, you know, something related to tire. Do you want to buy, you know, a car, you know, or something, you know? So the advertising is very targeted because they know me right away. When I go to some section, they know exactly what I'm looking for before I know, you know, and they advertise. So this is beacons. So basically, advertising based upon proximity, your phone broadcasts its presence if Bluetooth is turned on. So Bluetooth is on, you're telling the world that I'm here, right? Primary aim of these broadcasts is to allow device discovery. When the IEEE put it in, or, you know, or the Bluetooth 6 put it in, it was to find each other, right? But now, the marketing people have found it. Advertising packets consist of who I am I, and basically MAC address, and then, you know, so you can figure out the distance. from the signal strength. And iOS 7, after the iOS 7, iOS is the operating system on the iPhone, version 7, they have started sending and receiving beacons, right? So can be used for customized advertising, indoor location, and geofencing. So customized advertising is what I talked about, is that they know who am I, so they can just give me the what I need. Indoor location, I can figure out where am I, because they know that this is me, and this is a phone, this is that. So they can figure out, and my phone can figure out as well where I am. Geofencing on the dog. You put it on the dog, and if it crosses the boundary, your phone rings that it has gone out on the road. And so that is called geofencing. You know, distance, this thing. And PayPal uses this to identify you. You can pay using a PIN and your phone. So if you bring your phone and you put a PIN number here, that indicates that you are there, because your phone is there and you know the PIN. So it's something you know and something you have, two items. And then you don't need a credit card. Why it is not secure? Suppose you get my phone, you don't know the PIN. This is like a credit card. No, this is the PIN is not in the phone. PIN is in my brain.
When you enter the brain for the first time,
the guy on the other side. Yeah. So the thing is, if somebody puts something in the any payment device, which they do, then they can hack me, right? And so even if it's a credit card, it's the same thing. If I put a credit card, I slide a credit card through, if there is something on the other side, they can record it. That's what they used to do before. Actually, in the past, you used to have paper transactions, right? So your credit card was scanned on a paper, right? And that paper was used to be thrown in the garbage, and the garbage collectors used to just read the credit card number. You remember those days? Yeah, okay. So now we don't do any paper transactions, but now there is electronic snooping. So anyway, this is, so most of the new payment systems, whether it is Apple Pay, PayPal Pay, or, you know, I don't know what Samsung calls, Google Pay or whatever, right? They are based upon this principle, basically, that, you know, you have something and you know something. Actually, credit card that way is very unsafe, because it doesn't depend upon what you know. It just depends upon you have it. If somebody gets my credit card, they can as well use it, right? Except in the new credit cards, which are, I don't know, how does it improve any security? But anyway, and they have these chips, right? But they don't ask me anything. So I think it's still as insecure. But anyway, beacons. So this is something you have to be aware of. My phone is always, this one, Bluetooth is off all the time. And the inconvenience is that when I get into the car, I can't get myself my phone calls, right? If it is on, then my car has a Bluetooth, my phone has a Bluetooth, I can just drive and talk, right? But now without this Bluetooth being on, that doesn't work. Other than that, I don't miss it that much. Okay, so the Bluetooth in the car is also advertising. So if somebody wanted to figure it out that, you know, I'm passing through this bridge or I'm passing through this and that, they will know. I mean, they can track me, right? However, having said that, there is a license plate in my car which can be used to track me as well. I mean, anybody can see that I'm passing, you know, with that car. You see? So it's not... No, license plate, anybody can take a picture, right? I mean, they can put a camera and say, okay, this car passed, and so this Rajan must have passed through this at 10 o'clock. Come on. I mean, the thing is, license plate is a big advertising sign that I'm here. So the Bluetooth is doing not much to it, right? So yeah, so the thing is, when you say safe, it's a matter of privacy. With Bluetooth, privacy is compromised. Okay? But it's also done a little bit with other wireless technologies. Wi-Fi, same thing. So here's what happens. When you come to this room with Wi-Fi enabled laptop, it does broadcast. It does say that, okay, I'm looking for somebody. When it says I'm looking for somebody, it does have the source address in it, source MAC address. It's the same thing. Except that in the old days, not everybody used to have Wi-Fi, take it to the store and, you know, things like that. Now with the phone, Bluetooth is, you know, everywhere. I mean, basically everybody has a Bluetooth, walking Bluetooth with them, and it is on all the time. So it has become more privacy issue. All right, that brings us to the end of this module. So the five key points, Bluetooth basic rate uses, okay, so I have used the word Bluetooth basic. I should say Bluetooth classic. Bluetooth original, whatever, Bluetooth classic uses frequency hopping over 79 1 megahertz channels, and the packet sizes are 1, 3 and 5. Slot. Each slot is how long? Yeah, 625 microseconds. By this time, you should have, because I have said so many times that one, right? Three inactive states. So there are total eight states we saw. In the bottom, there were three states: hold, sniff, and park. Right? Out of this, which one is the most sleeping state? Has a fixed up, and then the original classic had a very fixed set of applications. You know, some 13, 15 applications, they were described in the standard. And so the other one actually, which will come in a minute, but Bluetooth and Wi-Fi can coexist by time sharing or frequency sharing. In the time sharing mode, we have two kinds of time sharing, either by just slot by slot or by, you know, by packet by packet, right? And then you could have collaborative or non-collaborative. In the collaborative, you know exactly what you're doing because you're control of both. In the non-collaborative, you have to guess from the errors. Bluetooth Smart is designed for short broadcast. So they use 39 2 megahertz channels. First of all, the width has gone up from 1 to 2. And so instead of 79, we now have actually total 80 megahertz. And 39 times... No, actually, I think there were 40 because there was channel number 0. 0 to 39, I think there are 40 channels there. 2 megahertz. And with three channels are reserved. 37, 38, 39 are reserved for advertising. And those are used by many sensors just to send data. And otherwise, if you want to do sustained data, then you use those for connection. And then you do the data on the other ones. And then this, there is this new profile, generic attribute profile. And its purpose is so that now we can send almost anything in the world as long as it has a number either given by Bluetooth SIG or by the manufacturer. Right? And then new profiles can be defined easily. Okay? All right. So there is a homework. So assume that one slot in Bluetooth, 256 bits of payload could be transmitted. So in 625 microseconds, you can send 256 bits of payload. Okay. How many slots are needed if the payload size is 512 bits, 728 bits, and 1024 bits? Three different sizes. So that says how much slots, right? Assumes that the non-payload portions do not change. Okay, so there is a payload and there is a header. So you X plus 256. X plus 512, X plus 728, X plus 1024. Yeah, so X you can calculate actually. So 256 bits on 625 microsecond. So the X is, you can calculate X. Yeah, so you once you get that, assume that the non-payload portion does not change. Yeah, so you just use that X for all of these. Do you understand? You first get X from 256.
Yeah.
Okay, then use that X with 512 and figure out how many slots that is. Okay, and then 728, how many slots that is, and then 1024, how many slots that is. And please read, as I said before, the people who read actually do much better. People who don't read, basically they are in the bottom part of the class.